I would like to think that somewhere in the world, like, there's a fan club of people who, when they were like kids, watched Little Frog Learns English. That, like, that's my dream, really. I hope that one day I will discover that that is the case. Today I want to talk about unjs. I've prepared a very short presentation of about 30, 40 minutes to talk about 50 libraries that I think can transform your life. Unjs is a GitHub organization. You can access it, github.com/unjs. And it's all about creating utilities that anyone can use, that work everywhere, that enable best practices. And this happened because, I should say, by the way, I'm Daniel, and I'm involved in a lot of different things. You might know me from Nuxt. I'm leading the Nuxt core team. I'm also involved in unjs, of course. I've created a library to make my regular expressions magical. Another one to get rid of font layout shift. I'm one of the team building Elk, a Mastodon client, which you should definitely check out. I'm some other things as well. And you can find me on Twitter if you want to message me and ask any questions or whatever. And Mastodon. unjs is a library all about universal JavaScript. It's created really out of Nuxt. So we found that we were using utilities, creating utilities that we were using internally, but we didn't want these to be ecosystem specific. We didn't want them to be Nuxt only. And so as much as possible, we tried to pull them out, collaborate with other people, make them useful for as many people as possible. And so my aim today, I'd love to tell you all about Nuxt, but I'm not going to. I'm going to tell you all about the utilities we created out of it that you can use in your project, whether or not you're using Nuxt. So here's one, and I've got to be quick, I realize that. Ofetch, it's an opinionated wrapper for native fetch. It uses the same API, but it gets rid of all the pain. So you can just create like a pre-configured fetch instance. Maybe you're used to doing that with Axios. You can maybe set a base URL or add some like interceptors. And then you just call it. It will handle, if it's a JSON response, they'll come back, it will handle pulling it out and making it an object. It's also fully typed. We use it in Nuxt under the hood to provide typed access to our own internal API routes. And it works everywhere. It works in the browser with fetch in the browser. It works in Node using Node native. And it should be, I use it everywhere. Utilities, scripts, give it a go. We do quite a lot of things in Nuxt that have to be cross-environment. We want Nuxt to be deployable anywhere, to Cloudflare Workers, or to Dino, or to Bun, or anywhere. And so we've built a couple of utilities and libraries that enable that to work. And one of them is called unenv. So this is an example configuration from unenv. It includes lots and lots of stubs and mocks and things that basically you can drop into a build pipeline to make sure that libraries that don't work in your target environment are replaced with ones that do. And so this is how we can basically deploy the same app, even if it has hard dependencies on Node libraries, to a Cloudflare worker or to Dino or something like that. We also are able to use it to handle things like to replace large dependencies that aren't needed in a project. So things that are really big or might be useful in development mode, but you don't want to be bundled up in a worker environment. We use the same library again, unenv, together with ofetch, to actually enable bypassing the network layer entirely. So in Nuxt, we sort of hook them up, and it means that when you are performing a network call within your app, from one part of your app to another part of your app, so if you're rendering a view page, and you're performing a network request to your own API endpoint, we're able to make it like an internal function call. Everything looks like a network request from your app's perspective, but it's not. It's all fake. And actually, I was able to use this in building a native Towery app for Elk to move our entire server that the Elk app needed into the browser. So it was actually running in the browser, the server, and dealing with network requests that look like node ones with request and response object. And that is that's probably a terrible, terrible thing to do. You might be just thinking, goodness me, that's awful. But I thought it was cool at the time, and so that's why I'm telling you about it. But basically, you can do a lot of really interesting things. You can even sort of proxy or pass headers through. You can get pre-configured fetch requests. Sorry. I could go in and talk about this a lot, but it's fun. And a lot of other things along those lines. So we built a library called Uncrypto, which enables universal access in workers and a node to things like subtle crypto and the web crypto API. So you don't have to think about where you're deploying it. And if you've ever experienced platform incompatibility issues, I once tried to implement, like, to port my personal JWT implementation from node to Cloudflare workers. I thought, oh, this would be really simple. It was not simple. But basically, Uncrypto solves a lot of those kind of issues. You don't have to think about how it works. It just works. Browser, node, workers, anywhere. Path A is a drop-in replacement for node path that works in exactly the same way on Windows and Linux. So many problems and bugs in my life come from Windows. And Path A is our attempt to fix that forever. And yes, you can use that in the browser as well if you want. And UFO, URL normalization utilities. Did you know that the new URL constructor works in profoundly different ways in different browsers? And that if you're trying to use it to normalize things, it just doesn't work. Well, UFO lets you do things like combine URLs and add sort of extra segments to paths and parse queries and all kinds of things like that. You might find it useful in a project. H3. Sorry, I'm going really quickly, but there is so much to talk about. H3 is a different kind of framework. So it's like Express, but it's tree shakable. All the utilities are importable on demand, which means that your actual finished framework only includes the features you use. It's really intuitive. So you can do things like, so this example here, you can assert that it has to be a given method. You get the query string, or you get the body with simple composables. You can throw errors, which directly turn into error responses. If you want to return JSON, you just return it as an object, and everything just works. Use that for an API if you want. Probably use it as part of something of Nitro, which I'll tell you about in a second. We used H3 and this sort of tree-shakable approach to move our Nuxt cold start times from 300 milliseconds in Nuxt 2 to less than 2 milliseconds in Nuxt 3, which is necessary if you're wanting to run things on the edge. Like, you have to re-architect how it works. And H3 is lazy imported. It is it's a completely different way of doing things. And I would highly, use it. Give it a try. Unimport. If you love imports and writing them at the top of the file and reading through them at the top of the file before you get to the code that matters, unimport is not for you. It is all about getting rid of that friction between you and the code you're trying to see and understand. It works with TypeScript. It produces types so that you get the full IDE experience of knowing where it came from, still getting type support, still having the ability to click through to that code. But it means that you don't have to context switch. And we actually have two modes. One is where it just provides the import for you. And basically, we'll insert the import at build time to exactly the place where it needs to go. And the second is we actually have like a transform. So if you prefer to import things from something, you can do that too. And we use it everywhere. We use it in Nuxt. We use it in Nitro. And that is a lot of fun. So if you're using even Vite on its own, you can use unimport as well. And that is produced by the amazing Anthony Fu. By the way, the credit for all of these things, but it's not me, you mustn't think that. There's a lot of people, but Puya Parsa, Anthony Fu, and many others have created, and me also, I've created some cool libraries. If you're ever wondering what environment you're in and want to sort of handle things, use standard end. We use it to support zero config deployment to lots and lots of different providers. So with Nuxt, you can deploy to Cloudflare Pages or Vercel or Netlify or AWS Static Web Apps or Lagon or Stormkit, and they're all zero config. The user doesn't need to configure anything because we can tell what environment it is using standard end. You can also detect things like, are you running in CI? Do you have access to a console? Is it a testing environment? And you can enable different behavior. And obviously, we use that to reduce the DX pain of you know, having to configure that manually. But you might be able to use that in different situations as well. Unplugin. If you ever need to do some kind of build, you want to write like a plugin that's going to do something, which we do all the time. This came out of Nux's need to support both Webpack and Vite, which are both valid bundler options. We have an RSpack bundler PR in the works as well. But you can write plugins using unplugin syntax, the simple, beautiful rollup syntax. And it produces plugins at the end of the day, which can be used in ES build, in rollup, in Vite, in Webpack, in RSpack. When we added support for RSpack, all that was needed to add that feature to existing unplugins that already had been written was a PR to unplugin. And genuinely, once you've done this, you will never go back because you don't have to. No, I don't know if you're writing build plugins, but if you are, try this one. And this build plugin will remove comments from your Vue code. If you want to do that and not render them in the HTML, that's all it takes to do it. And it works in all of those different environments. Unstorage, it is a provider agnostic. A lot of what we do is provider agnostic. We're trying to build stuff that works everywhere and for everyone. I hate lock-in. I couldn't imagine anything worse. I am loyal to the providers I'm loyal to because I think they're great and they give good value or they give good DX or they fit my requirements. I hate lock-in. Unstorage is a KV store. So it supports lots and lots of drivers. There are some of the ones that are built in, but you can add your own really, really easily in your own projects. You can add one in 12 lines of code. You can mount different providers to different bits of your storage, so prefixed by different keys, and then you can read and write them asynchronously. And that is so much fun. So again, for our Elk Mastodon client, we use this so that people forking it and deploying it in different places could opt into different providers, whether that's the file system in development or memory or Redis or Cloudflare KV storage, PlanetScale, and there were others. And this is all can be done dynamically at runtime. And it really, really improves DX because you don't have to think about the implementation details when you're coding. It's purely a question of setup. Magicast, you can programmatically modify JavaScript and TypeScript files. So there's an example, minimal file, you run that code and you get this out the other end. We use it in Nux so that from the Nux dev tools, you can click install a module. It modifies your Nux config to add the module to it and make any other changes that are required. So again, it improves developer experience. You can use it for anything. Someone built like a VS Code extension for Nux that does exactly the same kind of thing. Check it out, it's really cool. And Nitro is probably one of the flagship projects that we've built in unjs. You can use it to deploy servers that run anywhere, that are universal. It uses everything else that I've shown you in the project. And it is really optimized. I don't have time to talk about how optimized, but it took us, for example, a 50 meg bundle in Nux to something under 3 in Nux 3. I've mentioned the cold start. Check it out. I've given a talk where I build a full stack React meta framework built on Vite on stage. It's really easy to, and that's not because I'm fast, that's because it's fun. So check it out. I would love to see more people using some of these libraries and some of the others. These aren't all of them. These are just the ones that I like of the rest of the unjs ecosystem. Like particularly, I mean, I like them all. That's it. I'm sorry. I don't have any time to dive into more of them, but I really hope you use them. I really hope you like them. Please DM me, contact me on Twitter, make a PR. If there's any way I can help you or our project, or if you want to ask a question about one of them, I would love to do that. Thank you so much. It's been a real pleasure and an honor.